Because what you got to remember as well is when you first put a lot of them in that potential tag, they were a load of shit. Because you would have just wanted to, you know, you would have taken every yes for an answer, like, yep, sweet, perfect, he's interested, when really they weren't.
It's all about happiness, baby. What makes you happy? What makes you tick?
Okay, right, let's get straight into it. Before we get into the nitty-gritty sort of ScreenFlow stuff, okay, what I wanted to do, because it's really, really important, is to give you a brief understanding about how Facebook works in general, all right? Because it's something not a lot of people talk about. And for someone that's just starting out, that's probably like you, otherwise you wouldn't have brought a crash course like this, it's really, really important that you know this before going into it, okay? Just to give you that just brief overview, general knowledge about how Facebook and the algorithm and all that complicated stuff work at a very, very basic level. This is what I've taught on stage before, and in a lot of my other trainings I've taught this to companies when I've gone in and consulted with them, and it really just sort of opens their eyes and, you know, makes something click that says, ah, okay, I understand this now. So hopefully that's going to do the same for you. Vlog, how's it going? We're up in the conference room today filming a brand new training that we're just about to launch. You know, one of the things that I keep seeing in the market at the moment is there's a lot of people, especially now in the current climate, right, with everything that's going on, there's businesses folding left, right and center. Facebook ads and just paid advertising in general really can really help businesses. Big problem is a lot of them just haven't got a clue how to do it, and they just don't know how to start. And there's a lot of noise out there. There's a lot of guys in their bedrooms making trainings because they've read something somewhere on Facebook and now they're selling it for hundreds of pounds, you know. So what I'm going to do, based on all of our knowledge here at Einstein Market, you know, for those of you guys that don't know, we're a marketing agency that spends over 400 grand at the moment a month, every month, on paid advertising. So, you know, we really do know this stuff. So I'm putting together a training for Facebook specifically for beginners, people that haven't yet got started but need to, or people that have got started but it hasn't worked for them for whatever reason, probably because they've been taught badly. And I'm putting it together in a condensed training called the Facebook Ads Crash Course. And we're up here at the moment, me and Billy, just been filming some videos are on here, most of it, because I've condensed it to be like, you know, sort of 4 hours. I want it to be really short so no one's got any excuses, because the only goal is just to get them started. You know, it's not to make them a absolute whiz, because that would take a lot longer. I just want to get them started. So most of the training is on like my screen, where I record my screen and teach them so they can actually see me doing it. But then there's a couple of videos that have been up here, so we're just up here at the moment filming this. That's why I'm buzzing. It's like we got in early today, so it's about 8:30 in the morning. I'm full of energy, because anytime I sort of teach this stuff I just get really, really passionate about it, and I'm just like, I'm all fired up. Video's gone well so far. Got a few more to do today, a few more bits to do this afternoon, training with the team and things like that. For the most part, it's gonna be a good day, because we'll be launching this next week. You know, I'm a big action taker. If I get an idea, I wanna implement it straight away. I had this idea last week. We're already filming it. The copy's already done for the page. Page is now being designed. Should be able to launch it out to the public next week. So you'll probably be seeing loads of annoying ads of me trying to get people to join this program. You get their information because they're interested, okay? And then after that, the leads that we've got there, we then, you might call them up. So the next part of the process might be a phone call with one of your team, where you sell them. If you're in some sort of service-based industry, service-based niche, this is a really, really good strategy. And then from there on the call, they're then sold something. Yeah, it might be a little bit different. You might be promoting something purely online and you want the transaction to be completely commerce based, right? All online. So that might look like this: an ad to a landing page. Still, we're still going to try and capture the lead. Still going to capture the lead. But then what we're going to do is we're going to take them to a sales page of some sort, where we're gonna get them to buy something. Apologies for my writing again. Hopefully by now you can decipher hieroglyphics. Sales page, all right? And then from there, what we're gonna do is call that person up, because they're now a customer, and we're going to sell them something else, maybe our products or services. Maybe it just stops there. Maybe all of the people that are coming to your landing page or going straight to your sales page, maybe all of them don't buy right then and there. What is the process? Do we have a follow-up process in place? I'm constantly seeing a new ad, and because I save any ad that catches my attention, I save it. And the last five I've seen from them, I cannot save because I've already saved it. They've just changed the fucking image where I'm being retargeted. Especially now with the direct, for instance, like, everyone that's watched, that's registered for a webinar, really, in both regions, should go there. I think we should be pushing that to them. And then if they don't watch that, then the new direct that I've done now, by the way, but I'm just waiting for the ads from Vince, and be sending that one group of audience, sending them, they should be being targeted in a couple of different campaigns, I reckon. I finally converted when I went through, mainly because I was doing a bit of competitive research, but the main reason was I just kept seeing their fucking ads, man. I just kept seeing their ads, and I was only a landing page visitor. I was not a lead. So don't forget that as well. Don't forget that core principle in marketing. People don't buy from you the first time, or the second, or the third. It's the fourth, the fifth touch where they actually convert and become that customer. I think we, you know, really start honing in on that sort of shit now as well. Just looking at their, definitely worth just keeping an eye on their ads, especially you, Kyle, because you're doing the Einstein stuff. The images they use, really, really clever images, and then it just slightly relates to it in the ad copy, and it works. Yeah, because like when we get our stuff sorted, we're gonna need to be bang on that, because we're gonna have probably five or six different things launched at the same time. They'll be promoted at the same time. So we've got to make sure that our retargeting strategy is bang on. I think the direct one now, because all the other campaigns have been running so long and the direct one hasn't, we could create that audience for that direct as well. Because again, a lot of the people that registered for the webinar wouldn't have sat through it. You know, the average watch time on the webinar, however long, you know, fuck knows what the actual percentage of people watching till the end is. It's probably like 20-odd%, 30%. I mean, 70% of people haven't actually even seen that offer yet. So with the direct video, the offer's, it's basically there straight away. It's book a call, speak to us, you know, that sort of thing. Yeah. Have you been calling through them yet?
Of course, went through all that list this morning.
What, potentials?
And only one of them answers.
Oh, really? Fucking hell. Because what you've got to remember as well is when you first put a lot of them in that potential tag, they were a load of shit. Because you would have just wanted to, you know, you would have taken every yes for an answer, like, yep, sweet, perfect, he's interested, when really they weren't. You don't know enough about them. They're definitely not sold enough on it. So I would go into those, like you've spoken to them before, but I'd still try and get through it, because they're still going to need to be excited about it, because there's a good chance in week one, week two, when you were here and you did speak about it, it wasn't enough for them to actually be interested. So I'd look at them, you know, just say, yeah, we spoke a couple of weeks ago, listen, and the reason for the call is because tickets are now on sale. That's what I would say, because before when you spoke about it, they weren't. So you can go into the call and say, yeah, just thought I'd touch base because tickets are now on sale for EMC. Now, I know we spoke really, really briefly about it, but I've got a lot more information for you now because the tickets are on sale. And I'm just going to run through that with you now. Is that okay? Yeah, that's fine. And then go boom, straight into it.